So, it's seen from the statement of triangle of vector addition. The magnitude of the resultant of two vectors. Given by this formula. Okay. So now the three special cases of this. Okay. If the angle between two vectors happens to be 90 degrees, then your vector triangle looks like this. So this is the case where angle between them is 90 degrees. So as you can see in the diagram, the resultant simply becomes this hypotenuse. So for this case, theta equal to 90 degrees, this result becomes magnitude of a plus b is root of a square plus b square, because cos 90 is 0. So you can see in the formula. But if you take the case where theta is an acute angle, then the same vector triangle will have this kind of a shape. So here theta is less than 90 degrees. So you can see as a result of that, the magnitude of the sum will become longer than you can see in this vector, no? So you can see that a plus b will become a vector such that mod a plus b is greater than root of a square plus b square when theta is less than 90 degrees, because cos theta will be a positive quantity when theta is less than 90. Whereas on the other hand, if you see the situation where the angle is obtuse between two vectors, that would be a situation looking like this, let's say. So here theta is greater than 90 degrees. So in this case, you can see that the resultant is like this. And both from the formula as well as the geometry of the triangle, you can understand that magnitude of a plus b will become less than root of a square plus b square when theta is greater than 90 degrees, or it's an obtuse angle. So cos theta becomes a negative quantity as we discussed, whereas here cos theta is a positive quantity. Okay. So this was one of the important things that we discussed in the last lecture towards the end. So there's a quick recap of that. So just go through it and let me know if there's any doubt about this section. I don't think there should be, because we have discussed this last time and I've given you some questions where you will be applying this concept. Hitanshu, theta is the angle between two vectors. So the angle between two vectors is not this one, it is this one. If you see a vector A like this and another vector B like this, this is the direction of A. So to turn that to the direction of B, you have to rotate by this theta. Okay. It has no connection with this theta. So the angle between the two vectors is this angle, is the angle between the direction of one vector and the direction of another vector. So that is this one. So that is this one. So I hope that is clear by now because I have gone through this n number of times. Yes, okay, good. Right. Now we had also seen that overall cos 0 is 1. This is the maximum possible value of cos theta. And cos 180 is minus 1. This is the minimum possible value. Of cos theta. So therefore we also saw that for theta equal to 0, cos theta becomes 1 and magnitude of a plus b becomes root of a square plus b square plus 2ab. So that becomes a plus b. Okay, but for theta equal to 180 degrees, cos theta becomes minus 1 and magnitude of a plus b therefore becomes root of a square plus b square minus 2ab. So that is nothing but magnitude of a minus b. Okay. Make sure that you understand that it is mod of a minus b because this can't be a negative quantity. So we have an example where a is let's say 5 and b is 7. Then this quantity square root of a square plus b square minus 2ab will not be minus 2, it will be 2 only. So that's why there's a mod sign over here. Okay, so these are the two extreme cases. Okay, so therefore, in general, we say that magnitude of a plus b always ranges in a value between the difference of the two magnitudes and the sum of the two magnitudes. This is the case where it is maximum. When theta is 0, this is a case where it is minimum when theta is 180 degrees. Okay, anyway, so with this quick recap, let's hit the questions of assignment 2. So, can you tell me if you which are the questions which you want to discuss? Might have tried out and had some difficulty. Just let me know which are the questions you might have had any difficulty in assignment 2. Okay, question number 9, 10, 15, and 30. Okay, so let's start with question number 9. Anybody has a doubt in question before question 9? Anything before question 9, please drop me a message. Okay, question 8. So 4 also. Okay. So let's start with question 4. Okay, Janvi, I'll start with question 4. So question 4 is saying that a person walks 2 kilometers due north and then turns and walks 1.5 kilometers due east. The magnitude of the net displacement is how much? Okay. So this you can understand by just drawing a vector diagram. If this is your general north, south, east, west kind of direction, then the person is first walking 2 kilometers due north. So that is, let's say that is the first displacement. It's in this direction. S1 is 2 kilometers towards north. Then he turns and walks 1.5 kilometers towards the east. So the second displacement now is going to be like this. Like this. It's 1.5 kilometers towards east. This is the second displacement. So the net displacement is going to be nothing but the vector from the initial position to the final position, and that is the sum of these two displacements. So this you can see is the resultant or the net displacement. So you have to find the magnitude of this net displacement. You can see that since this is a right angle triangle, that is going to be nothing but square root of this. So that is 4 plus 2.25. Okay. So that is square root of 2.5 whole square on 2.5 kilometers. Okay, so hope this is clear. Just make a quick note of this. Okay, so hope this is clear, Janvi. Okay, let us come to question 6 next. Very good. Okay, so what's happening in question 6 is that we have two vectors of magnitude 10 each and the angle between them is 60 degrees. So given to us that magnitude of the vector A is equal to the magnitude of the vector B, which is 10, and the angle between them is 60 degrees. So we have to find A plus B's magnitude. So I'd like you to pay close attention to this question. We can do this question in two ways actually. One is we can do it by formula based method. Okay. So apply this. So substitute in this. Okay, so substitute these things. So cos 60 is half, so cos theta should be half, so this becomes root of 10 square plus 10 square plus 2 into 10 into 10 into half. Okay, so this becomes square root of 100 . This is the first thing. This is the formula based method. Okay, so make a note of this, but in the meantime we'll also find out the geometrical method. Okay. So in this method we will construct a vector triangle for vector sum of A and B. Okay, and find it out from there. But anyway, first in the meantime, you write down this part. Okay, so hope you worked out the triangle also. Not necessarily, the geometry method is also very easy, Tanchu. I'll explain to you. Just waiting for you to try it out yourself. You don't try out, you will not learn these things. So anyway, so if we draw this geometrically, let's see how this looks. Let us say this is our vector A, then our vector B will be something like this. Same magnitude but at an angle of 60 degrees to it. This is our vector A of magnitude 10. This is our vector B of magnitude 10 also. But this angle between them is 60 degrees. Okay. So now in this diagram, my resultant sum is going to be this vector. So notice the triangle that I'm getting, it's an isosceles triangle. So I can make use of some property of that isosceles triangle. And that property is that if these two sides are equal, then these two angles will be equal. Okay. And their sum will be equal to this angle. So first of all, I can make use of this property. Thirty degrees because this is 60. Okay. So accordingly, what is happening in this triangle now? You can see that this is telling us that this angle will be 30 degrees and this angle will be 30 degrees. Okay. Then the other property we can make use of an isosceles triangle is that in any isosceles triangle, if we drop a perpendicular, from the equal sides, okay, onto the third, I mean from the vertex of the equal sides, if we drop a perpendicular, so if this side is equal to this side, and drop a perpendicular onto the third side, so if we drop this perpendicular here, then this perpendicular bisects the third side. So this bisects this side now. So if this is x, this also becomes equal to x. And if this angle is alpha, this angle is alpha. And if this side was A, we already saw this side was A. Okay. So here, how that will work out is that if we drop a perpendicular like this over here, then this is equal to this. Okay. So you can see that in this triangle, magnitude of A plus B is equal to 2x, which we are trying to find out. Okay. Now coming back here, you can see that x by A in this triangle x by a is base upon hypotenuse, so it is cos alpha. So we can say x is a cos alpha. So we can make use of this. Just like we made use of this, we can make use of this. Okay. So x is equal to, now a here is 10 and alpha is 30 degrees, so it is 5 root 3. Therefore, magnitude of a plus b is 10 root 3. So you can see that making use of these two properties of the isosceles triangle, this property here and this property here, we can come up with a nice innovative solution of this question. So this is not the standard formula-based approach. This is something where we are making use of some other property of geometry that we know beforehand because it's an isosceles triangle. We can come up with a nice solution for this. Just make a note of this, then we will move on from here to question number 8. Okay, seventh question is a continuation of this. It's just asking you for this angle alpha, this one 30 degrees. So in both the methods, you can see how you calculated 30 degree. In the earlier method, you would have to use the formula for tan alpha, that formula, that is b sine theta upon a plus b cos theta. Here you are directly getting it as 30 degrees. Okay, so this angle also 30 that you're getting, I'll show you from above that you can get it by the formula based method also, but it's much quicker by the isosceles triangle method. Okay, so if you wanted to understand how this angle is coming 30 by formula based method earlier, you can see that also. So in this method, if you wanted to find the angle between the resultant vector A plus B and E, that angle is alpha, you would have to use this formula that tan alpha is b sine theta upon a plus b cos theta. So in this you would substitute a and b as 10, sine theta is root 3 by 2, cos theta is half because theta was 60 degrees. So ye sab substitute karne ke baad we would get like this, 10 into root 3 by 2 upon, in the denominator you can take 10 common. Okay, so you would end up getting root 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. So that is 1 by root 3. Okay, so you would have got tan alpha is 1 by root 3, that means alpha is 30 degrees. So quite a bit of effort, but here you can see you are getting that alpha directly. This angle only is alpha. It is the angle between the resultant A plus B and the vector A. Okay. So that has been asked in the tutorial sheet or in the worksheet as question number 7. So you can see that that is part of this same situation. either you're using the formula or you're using this. Yeah, so hope this is fully clear to all of you. Now moving on to question number 8. So 8 is again formula based, where you can, I mean, 8 is again an application of sum of two vectors. So just like this question, in 8 also you can choose an option. You can either do it by drawing the vectors and trying to solve it geometrically, or you can use the formula based approach. Okay, so magnitude of A is equal to magnitude of B, okay, and the angle between them is 120 degrees. So if you go by formula based method, mod A plus B, okay, so let us say this is, suppose, some x, suppose, okay, so then this becomes root of x square plus x square plus 2x square cos 120. Okay, now cos 120, you know, is minus cos 60, so it is minus half. So this becomes x square plus x square plus 2x square into minus half. This whole thing is inside the square root. So as you can see, it becomes this, it becomes x. So therefore, your conclusion is that mod of A plus B is equal to mod A, is equal to mod B, is equal to x when theta is 120 degrees. Okay. Now likewise, for this one also, the geometrical approach is very, very simple, because you can understand the moment you are dealing with this. Moment you're dealing with this situation where this angle is 120 and this side is equal to this side, you're dealing with an equilateral triangle. You can see, this is your resultant of A plus B, okay, but this time, once again, since this angle is equal to this angle, okay, so 2 alpha is equal to theta again, so that means alpha is becoming 60 degrees, that means it's becoming an equilateral triangle. Okay, so equilateral triangle is again showing you this result. Okay, so hope this question number 8 is clear to all of you. Now we'll be moving on to question number 10, I think, from here. Achha, 9 also. Okay, so next up, finish taking a note of this and come to question 9 after that. Good. So question 9, try it out yourself. I'll give you a hint. Okay. Use triangle law formula. Okay. And put theta equal to 45 degrees or cos theta equal to 1 by root 2. You can do this, or use triangle inequalities that we have discussed. what we discussed the first part today, the triangle inequalities. Try to see if you can make use of that faster. So this is the method, better method here compared to this, because you know this will give you the faster result.
Not very nice.
Okay, so hope you have worked out question 9. So see, it's pretty simple that we know that in general mod a plus b is less than a plus b, I mean less than equal to and greater than equal to a minus b. Okay, and this case is for theta equal to 0 when cos theta is 1. So therefore, if theta is less than 90 degrees, is greater than 0. If theta is greater than 0, for example, here theta is 45 degrees, cos theta is less than 1. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2, which is approximately 0.7. So therefore, you can see that magnitude of a plus b is less than a plus b. It's just theorem wise only. Okay, so this is by using the inequality, using the triangle inequality. Okay, if you want to go by formula based method, you substitute. So this you can see is like this. Okay, so you can see that this is a square plus b square plus root 2ab. Okay, now notice that. Okay, now next thing, that root of a square plus b square plus square root 2ab is less than root of a square plus b square plus 2ab. So that means is less than this. So less than a plus b. Okay, so which in place implies that for theta equal to 45. But the thing is, we don't need to solve so much. It's a unnecessarily lengthy way of analyzing the problem. We already know from our analysis of the triangle inequality, which is why we learned this as a theorem separately, that theta agar 0 se jyada hai, if theta is greater than 0, then definitely cos theta will be less than 1. Yes, so then definitely your mod of a plus b will be less than the sum of the magnitudes. So hope this is clear. People who have asked question number 9, some multiple students have asked question number 9. So all of you, hope this is clear. Yeah, Itanshu, is it clear to you now how we have used the triangle inequality? Yeah, I'm aware you are having the test next week. Don't worry. So everything you're learning right now is part of what will be important from the test point of view. Okay. Next, what are we solving? I think we are doing question 11, is it? So I'll discuss question 10. Okay, now this is a more interesting type of question. It says that the resultant of A plus B is perpendicular to E and has a magnitude which is double of A. Okay. So let us say we are writing the vector R as the resultant of A plus B. Okay. So R is the resultant, or you can say resultant sum, or simply sum, so many different ways we can call it, of vectors A and B. Okay. Now what is given to us in the problem is two things. That one is that resultant is perpendicular to A, and the other is that the magnitude of the resultant is 2 times the magnitude of A. Okay. Now see, the thing is that whenever you see something like this, now there is a perpendicular thing involved, you should jump to the conclusion that geometry will be easier. R is perpendicular to A, so that means that the vector triangle is a right angle triangle. Okay, so it's going to be easy to solve. It's going to be easy to solve by which method? Geometrically. So your first shot at the problem, you know, the first way you attempt the question, you should get the hint ki kahin pe diya hua that any two vectors are perpendicular. Either A was perpendicular to B, but that's not in this case. In this case, the resultant is perpendicular to A. So immediately you understand that the triangle you're dealing with is a right angle triangle. So you don't need to do anything else. You just need to draw that triangle geometrically. It'll be very easy because you have Pythagoras theorem and you have trigonometry. You have two easy things to deal with. So the first method you should go with is the geometrical method. You should try and solve this geometrically. Okay. So just draw the vector triangle. I want all of you to try this. Draw the vector triangle which gives you, which corresponds to this information. And you'll see it's very easy to get the answer from that. Draw the vector triangle and just use Pythagoras theorem in that triangle. It'll not take you more than a minute or two. Just try this out. Okay, so anybody got the answer? Yes, very good. Okay, Akash, that's correct. So you can see that यहाँ पे आपका वेक्टर ट्रायंगल कैसा दिखेगा? इफ दिस इज द वेक्टर ई विच हैज सम मैग्नीट्यूड कैपिटल ए, लेट्स से, देन द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ द टू हैज टू बी दिस वेक्टर नाउ. इट हैज टू बी परपेंडिकुलर ऑफ टू ए एंड डबल ऑफ ए इन मैग्नीट्यूड. So this has to be the resultant such that the magnitude is 2 times magnitude of A and it is perpendicular. So in this vector triangle, where is the vector B lying? The vector B has to be the hypotenuse. This has to be the vector B. So we have to find out how much the magnitude is, how much this angle is, suppose you want to find out. So you can see in this triangle that b square will be equal to e square plus r square, and r is equal to 2a. So b is equal to square root of e square. So magnitude of b is root 5 times magnitude. Therefore, mod b is to mod a will become root 5 is to 1. This is the easy way of doing the question. Okay, I will show you the formula-based method also, but it is unnecessarily complicated. If you go with the formula-based method, you have to make use of two things. One is that so in this substitute magnitude of R is 2a. So you have 2a is equal to root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. So square both sides. So you have this relation that okay, so this is your equation one. Okay. The other thing is your resultant is perpendicular to the vector E. So that means alpha is 90 degrees. So that means tan alpha, which is tan 90, is undefined. Okay, so tan alpha, which is b sine theta upon a plus b cos theta, this is undefined. Okay, so something is undefined means that the denominator of this thing must be zero. This one's denominator must be zero, then it is undefined. So that means a plus b cos theta should be 0. So this is your second equation. So then what you'll have to do is you'll have to substitute from here that cos theta is minus a by b. Substitute this in the first equation. So on substituting this, you have 3a square is equal to b square plus 2ab into minus a by b. So you have 3a square is equal to b square minus 2a square. So you have, now here b is the magnitude of a vector, so we won't take plus minus, we'll just take the magnitude root. So as you can see, this is the unrequired method. This is the much faster method to solve, because as I told you, the moment you see in a question that you have something which is perpendicular or you know you have two vectors of equal magnitude or something like that, you know that the triangle you will be dealing with will be a right angle triangle or an isosceles triangle or even an equilateral triangle or something simple like that, so it will be easier to handle. Okay, so Janvi and Hitanshu, both of you, I hope the answer is clear. And Akash, I hope you use the similar kind of method that we're discussing here for the geometrical method to solve. Yeah, if it is something more, you know, more generic, like it's not 90 degrees or anything like that, then you always have the formula-based method to apply. So you have to both know both the methods. Yes, Sumit, you can drop me a message, whatever it is, doubt you're having. Let's discuss 11th and 13th question next. Okay, 12th also. ठीक है, so let's come to 11th first. So magnitude of vector A is given to us as 12. Magnitude of vector B is given to us as 16. And is given to us that theta, the angle between them, is obtuse. Okay. That's the only information we have. So we know that when theta is obtuse, cos theta is negative. So therefore, magnitude of A plus B is going to be less than root of A square plus B square. This is again the inequality theorem that we saw earlier. So we know that magnitude of A plus B will be less than 20. Okay, because in this particular case, your vector diagram is going to look like this. This is 16, this is 12, but this is some angle greater than 90 degrees. Okay, so your resultant going to be like this. Whereas had it been the situation where theta had been 90 degrees, then your resultant would have been 20. Okay. If theta had been 90 degrees, then you can see that in this situation a plus b would have been 20, but here it is going to be some r where this r is going to be less than 20. You can see by comparing this with this or by using this inequality. So accordingly the answer should be that, okay. Let's come to 12th. So again, see, this is one where there are perpendicular vectors involved. Okay. It is given that A and B are perpendicular. Okay. And C is equal to minus 2B. So just basically draw the vectors now, and you'll get an idea about it. Draw some arbitrary vectors A, B, and C, and you'll get an idea about it. Okay. So let's assume the vector A is some arbitrary vector like this. Okay, this is the vector A. Then the vector B has to be perpendicular to this. So the vector B will have to be along this sort of direction. It doesn't matter B ka magnitude kitna hai, but directionally speaking, it has to be perpendicular. So now what can we say about the vector C? The vector C is such that magnitude of C is 2 times magnitude of B, and C's direction is opposite, okay, or at 180 degrees with respect to B. So in the same diagram now, my vector C should look like this. It's exactly opposite in direction. This is 180 degrees, but its magnitude is twice of B, whatever the magnitude of B is. So now you can see that therefore it's very easy to understand that A is perpendicular to C, A is perpendicular to D, B and C are opposite, or you can say anti-parallel vectors, okay, and of course the magnitude of C is 2 times the magnitude of B. So all these things are what we know, and we can accordingly select the options. Nahi, obtuse nahi beta, minus jab hota hai, that means it's opposite. This we have discussed in vector operations. माइनस का मतलब ही ऑपोजिट हो गया. एंड क्वेश्चन 13 वी विल मेक अ स्लाइट करेक्शन. आई थिंक देयर इज अ चेंज इन द आंसर की. Okay, the correct answer you should be getting should be 90 degrees. Any beta, yahan pe koi sum ki baat hi nahi hai na. So why you are using triangle law, Itanshu? Nothing has been asked in this question about triangle law, na? This is the relationship between the vectors. Okay, Rukh sir, you got it as 90 degrees as the angle. Okay, just make a correction in question 13. The answers are not correct, okay? There is actually some misprint in the question. So you should get the angle between F2 and F3 should be 90 degrees. So just try out this question yourself later. I'll just give you a basic hint for it. It is given that f1 plus f2 plus f3 is 0. Okay? Because the sum of the three forces is resulting in equilibrium. Equilibrium means net force is 0. Then the magnitudes are given that f1 is 100 newtons, f2 is 80 and f3 is 60. Now this statement here, ये जो given statement है, this implies that the vector f1 is negative of the sum of f2 and f3. So that implies that the magnitude of f1 is going to be equal to the magnitude of f2 plus f3. Okay. So if the angle between f2 and f3 is theta, then you can reduce this right hand side to this. Okay. Now, next, what you can do is you can substitute these values here and then use the equation to find out cos theta and from that theta. So, from this equation, then you find out cos theta. So, theta. So, when you do that, you will get theta is 90 degrees. Okay. So the correct answer will be 90 degrees. Actually, the question should have been the angle between F1 and F2, and then the answer would have been correct. But anyway, since it's between F2 and F3, this will be the angle. Okay, so question 13 is done. Now, anybody has a doubt in question 14 or 15? Okay, which one? Question 14 or 15? Okay, 14. Okay, so let's quickly look at question 14. Deepak, okay, fine. We'll discuss. Okay. So, question 14 mein dekho kya ho raha hai? It's given to us that we have these two vectors, one which is towards the west like this. So one is a horizontal force acting towards the west. Okay. Let's say this force is the force F1 or whatever. Okay. So it's of magnitude 10 newtons. Acting towards west. This is the north direction. Now we have the second force, F2, which is, or P or whatever. Okay. So that one is of some unknown magnitude. So let's say this is the force F2. Its magnitude is unknown, okay, but its direction is like this. So F2 and F2 is along 30 degrees east of north. So this is the east direction. So north se aap east ke taraf, you are turning by 30 degrees. So that is the direction of F2. Now we want to find P such that the resultant of F1 and F2 is towards north. Okay, so find the value of P so that the resultant of F1 and F2 points towards north. Okay, so you can understand here that in terms of vector algebra, how would you calculate the sum of F1 and F2? It would be like this. You draw the vector F1 first. So this is a vector which is well known. Its magnitude is also known, direction is also known. Then from the head of vector F1, you draw the vector F2. Oh, sorry, the vector F2 would be like this. It should be some vector like this. इसका मैग्नीट्यूड p है, बट जिसका इसके रिस्पेक्ट में एंगल कितना है 120 डिग्रीज. ओके, यू कैन सी द एंगल बिटवीन द टू वेक्टर्स. थीटा इज 120. दैट्स दिस. ओके, नाउ व्हाट वी वांट इज दैट दिस शुड बी सच दैट द रिजल्टेंट शुड बी अलोंग द नॉर्थ. So the resultant should be pointing in this sort of manner. This should be the resultant of F1 plus F2, but such that it's pointing towards north. So it's perpendicular to this. So once again, what you can do is you can make use of the fact that geometrically we have to solve. राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल इज मच इजी. ओके, सो दिस एंगल इज 60 सच दैट इन दैट ट्रायंगल यू कैन सी कॉस 60 इज द बेस विच इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ F1 अपॉन द हाइपोटन्यूज विच इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ F2. सो 10 बाई पी. सो कॉस 60 इज हाफ. So you can see P is 20 newtons. This becomes the final answer. So again, you know, there is a right angle involved somewhere. So the geometrical method is much easier, much more efficient of solving. Okay. So I'll leave you to try the formula based method in this. You can do that as practice. But as I've explained, always weigh your options before you start a question. Should I go with geometry? Should I go with formula? So if you see that there is some easy angle like 90 degrees or some two vectors are of same magnitude, so the triangle is going to be isosceles or something like that, which is going to make things easy, comes up, then just make use of that. Right, people, so hope you've understood this question. Answer is given as 10 root 3, is it? Let me just check. Question 14, the answer is given as D number. Achha, okay, it's wrong. So actually option A and D is same by mistake. That is the thing. Okay, just change the option D to 20. It's a misprint. Option A and D has become the same thing. D was supposed to be 20, A was supposed to be 10 root 3. So just change option D. Okay, keep option A the same as it is, but change option D to 20. Keep A the same, 10 root 3. That's just some typing mistake which has happened by mistake. Okay, so B and C keep them same. Okay, so this is the correct answer. Okay. Okay, now question 15. So question 15 is a good question in terms of your solving ability in trigonometry. So I'll give you some hint about how to solve it. Okay. Try it out. We'll discuss again if required. So question 15 mein kya keh raha hai, that P and Q are vectors in the ratio 1:2. So let us say mod P is X. So mod Q will become 2X because it's given to us that P is to Q. Okay. Now what else is given to us? That their resultant. So if vector R is the resultant of P and Q, then it is given that resultant makes an angle of this formula. This symbol is for tan inverse. Okay, so tan inverse of root 3 by 2 with respect to the vector P. Okay, so I'll explain what this means. So this basically we'll interpret it this way, ki if the angle between the resultant is at alpha with respect to P. So that given is that alpha is tan inverse of root 3 by 2. So that basically means that tan alpha is root 3 by 2. This is the meaning of this thing. Okay. So this statement, it has to be interpreted as this. Okay. And this other thing that was given, that P is to Q is 1:2, that has to be interpreted like this. Okay. So now you have to use the formula. Okay. So you have to use the formula for tan alpha. Now you know that in a general vector triangle, if this is P and you know this is Q or whatever, okay, then the resultant is this and this angle is alpha. So just use the formula of tan alpha. Okay. So this time this is X, this is 2X. This we don't know, but we know tan alpha. Tan alpha is going to be Q. This angle is theta. Q sine theta upon P plus Q cos theta. Okay. So we will now substitute this. So tan alpha is root 3 by 2. And we'll substitute this also. Q is 2x. And P is X. So we got this equation that root 3 times 1 plus 2 sine theta is, sorry, 1 plus 2 cos theta is equal to, on the other side, 2 into 2, 4 sine theta. Now this equation has to be solved for theta. Now that is where the challenging thing happens. This is a maths challenge. And how do we solve this? Okay. So anybody can give me a hint what to do now? Variable to mera ek hi hai, theta. बट इक्वेशन भी एक ही है एंड दैट इज साइन थीटा एंड कॉस थीटा. सो हाउ विल आई गेस द वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा फ्रॉम दिस और हाउ विल आई गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा. व्हाट आई कैन मेक यूज ऑफ ओवर हियर टू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा. So the hint is that whenever you have, yeah, let me see. And that is fine, but फिर भी मैं solve कैसे करेंगे? हाँ, convert sine to cos. तो कैसे convert करेंगे बेटा? Sine को cos में कैसे convert करेंगे? Om, what you are saying is correct. Okay, we have to change one of the two. या तो cos को sine में या sine को cos में. But कैसे करेंगे? So for that, let me tell you the hint. Use the identity between sine and cos. नहीं बट देन माई वेरिएबल विल चेंज ना बेटा. सो 90 माइनस थीटा को मैं सॉल्व कैसे करूंगा फिर ना. सो बेटर इज यूज दिस आइडेंटिटी दैट साइन स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा इज वन. ओके सो नाउ स्क्वायर बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द इक्वेशन. स्क्वायर दिस सो यू हैव थ्री टाइम्स वन प्लस टू कॉस थीटा का होल स्क्वायर इज 16 साइन स्क्वायर थीटा. इन दिस सब्स्टिट्यूट साइन स्क्वायर थीटा एज वन माइनस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा. सो ऑन डूइंग दिस सब्स्टिट्यूशन यू विल गेट अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन इन कॉस थीटा. सो सॉल्व कॉस थीटा हाउ मच दैट इज दैट्स फ्रॉम दैट यू विल गेट द वैल्यू थीटा. So this is a bit of a monster question in terms of solving, you know, because you have to do one more round of substitution, then solve that quadratic equation using that discriminant method. You know. So you'll get some kind of equation like this. You'll get an equation of this type: ax square plus bx plus c is equal to zero. But the only thing is that in that the variable x will be cos theta instead of being x. So then you use that method that x is minus b plus minus square root of discriminant by 2a. So all your experience in solving quadratic equations, you use that. Okay, so can you give this a shot using this method now? Okay. So I want to discuss some things ahead in theory. Okay, so I'd like to move ahead, just give it a shot later, try it out by this method, you'll get the answer. Now one more thing you can do here is see since options are given to you ना यहाँ पे मुझे आंसर निकालना भी जरूरी नहीं है. मैं ऑप्शन को सब्सटीट्यूट करके भी तो चेक कर सकता हूँ ना. सो आई हैव फोर वैल्यूज ऑफ थीटा गिवन टू मी. सो सब्सटीट्यूट ईच वैल्यू ऑफ थीटा इन द इक्वेशन. इफ लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड फॉर एनी वन बट दैट इज एन ऑप्शन दैट इज समथिंग विच विल वर्क ओनली इन एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस. ओके इट्स नॉट फॉर फुल सॉल्विंग. यू कैन ऑल्सो चेक द ऑप्शंस बाय सब्सटीट्यूटिंग थीटा ऑफ ईच ऑफ द ऑप्शंस इन दिस. But I suggest you try by both the methods. Okay. Okay. Now we will move on to the next thing in vectors, the next concept set in vectors, which is going to be the first of all difference of two vectors. So this is going to be like a second part of triangle law. But a sort of part two of triangle law. So when we are calculating the difference of two vectors, A minus B, okay, we can interpret this as the sum of the vector A with the vector minus B. Where minus b is a vector opposite to the vector b and having the same magnitude. You can make use of this concept. Okay. So that way we won't have to do anything new. We will just use the statement of triangle law for sum that we have discussed earlier. But for that sum, you know, what we'll do is we'll end up first applying it, or we will apply the sum formula, but not to the vector a and b, but rather to the vector a and minus of b. Okay, so if these were my two arbitrary vectors E and B, such that this angle is theta between them. Okay. So magnitude of the vector E is capital A, it's known to us. Magnitude of the vector B is capital B, it's known to us. And theta is known to us, that is the angle between A and B. Okay. So now the first thing we'll do is we will from this understand the vector minus B. So what is the vector minus B? The vector minus B is a vector opposite to B of same magnitude. Okay. So on my vector diagram now, this vector will look like this. The vector minus B will look like a vector like this. It's equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So this is my vector B. This is my vector minus B. V such that in this angle is theta because that angle was theta. So now to find out E minus B, I have to do this vector operation. I have to add the vector E with the vector minus B. So I have to add this vector here and this vector here. So let's see how that triangle looks like. So you pick up the vector E as it is from above and you draw it. But abhi us vector E mein mujhe kya add karna hai? I have to add the new vector minus B. So pick up that vector minus B from above and draw it over here. So this is your vector minus of B. It has a magnitude of B, but it is such that its angle with respect to the vector E will not be theta. Its angle will be 180 minus theta. B का डायरेक्शन जो था वो इस डायरेक्शन में था. सो दिस एंगल वॉज थीटा. सो वॉट अबाउट द एंगल दैट माइनस बी इज मेकिंग विद इट, दैट इज दिस एंगल. दिस इज गोइंग टू बी 180 माइनस थीटा. सो नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दीज टू. सो दैट इज दिस अदर वैक्टर, दिस वन फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन ऑफ ए टू दैट हेड ऑफ द वैक्टर वी एडिंग विच इज माइनस बी. सो दिस इज going to be my third vector, which is A minus B. Okay, and this is going to be some angle beta, let's say. So again we'll use triangle law only, but in triangle law we'll replace theta with 180 minus theta. Okay, so we are finding A minus B comma mod, which is mod of A plus of minus B. So this is going to be nothing but root of a square plus b square plus 2ab. But cos of what angle now? Cos of 180 minus theta. Because the angle between a and minus b is 180 minus theta. Okay. So now you use the trigonometric identity that this will become into minus cos theta, because we have that relation that cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Okay. So we will have magnitude of A minus B will give us this modified formula of the triangle law for the sum. Sum ke liye plus 2ab cos theta tha, difference ke liye minus 2ab cos theta ho gaya. So this formula, okay. And of course likewise tan of that angle will become b sine theta upon a minus b cos theta, because again here we are using the fact that sine of 180 minus theta is positive of sine theta. but cos is minus. So in the numerator, sine is left the way it is, but in the denominator, it becomes minus. So this two becomes the second part of triangle law. That is the law for the difference of two vectors. Okay, so just make a run through this and make sure you understand the steps we have used for the derivation of the formula. And of course, the most important thing for us will be the application of the formula. So this is the next learning for us in vector algebra, how to find the difference of two vectors. Okay, so understood this, I hope, people. Yeah, theta depends, it can be acute or obtuse. Okay, so we are taking the general case here. So you'll understand that with a couple of examples. It's not very difficult. So for example, first case, that given magnitude of vector E is 10, magnitude of vector B is 20, and the angle between them is 60 degrees. Find magnitude of A minus B. Work this out. And let's work out another example. The angle between them is 120 degrees, let's say. So find the magnitude of A minus B. Let me discuss. Yeah, so tell me the answers. I'm seeing a lot of people giving me the answers, but I want to see everybody. Okay. Yeah, correct, Om. Correct, Ruskar. Hitanshu, correct. Sumit, correct for the first one. We check the second one. Okay. So just apply the formula here. So mod a minus b is root of a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. So it is cos 60. Okay. So that's 100 plus 400 minus 200 हो जाएगा, है ना? Because you will substitute cos 60 as half. This will give you root 300, which you can write as 10 root 3. Now, likewise, just substitute here also. This is cos 120. Okay, but remember that cos 120 is minus cos 60 is minus half. So interestingly, this actually becomes minus 100 square. So this becomes 3 times 100 square. So this becomes 100 root 3. If you want to understand the geometry of each of these solutions, you will realize that in the first one, it looks like this. The vector A is of magnitude 10. Vector B would have been of magnitude 20 in this sort of direction at an angle of 60. But we would actually end up not doing this. We would use the vector minus B. So minus b would be this vector. So this would be the vector of magnitude 20, angle of 120 degrees here. So we would get our resultant of a and minus b, which would be the vector a minus b, is actually this one. This would be our a minus b. Now you see that this angle is 60 and this ratio is half, so actually this is 90. So you can also see this is actually a right angle triangle. You can also use, so alternately you can see that cos 60 is half, that's fine, and sine 60 is root 3 by 2, so that will be mod of a minus b upon 20. That's another reason why you can understand it's 10 root 3 here. Okay, and similarly, if you were to draw this triangle, you would see that the vector a is like this of magnitude 100, the vector b is like this of magnitude 100 at an angle of 120 degrees. So when we do the actual operation of a minus b, you draw the vector a of magnitude 100, but instead of b, we would draw the vector minus of b. So that would be this vector. This magnitude would be 100, but be at this angle is 60. So the difference of the two vectors would now be this one. this would be our e minus b. Okay. And for solving this triangle, you can make use of this isosceles triangle business. Drop a perpendicular here and all that. And from that, you'll be able to show that mod a minus b will come out to be 100. Okay, so hope this is clear to all of you, these questions. Okay. Now moving on to, we'll just take a quick introduction in the next few minutes to this thing, which we'll continue in the next lecture more properly. So component representation. Of vectors. So now we are moving ahead of what we learned before, which was geometrical representation. Now we are moving from geometrical representation to component representation. So essentially what we do in component representation of vectors is that we make use of, so vectors are represented in terms of, or you can say in relation to, a coordinate frame. So it's like making use of coordinate geometry. Okay. So if we have a vector, which is in the xy plane, such that the vector is of magnitude A and at an angle theta, then this vector A is represented in component form as the sum of its x component and y component. Okay. Where the x component of the vector is nothing but, now I'm drawing it for you, you'll understand. So the x component of the vector is nothing but this one, and the y component of the vector is nothing but this one. So the vector itself becomes the sum of these two perpendicular vectors. Okay. So the x component is written as ax into I cap, and the y component is written as ay into j cap. So this vector here is ax into I cap. This is ay into j cap, and therefore the vector A is ax I cap plus ay j cap. Okay, where now we need to understand the nomenclature clearly. What is each of these things? So in this, I cap is a unit vector along the positive x-axis. J cap is the unit vector along positive y-axis. Okay. So unit vector means what? Unit vector is a vector of magnitude unity one. Okay. So I cap is specifically a vector of magnitude one along the x-axis. Okay, j cap is specifically a vector of magnitude 1, but along which direction? Along the y-axis. Okay, so this is the component representation. Of the vector E. Okay. And of course, here AX and AY are scalars. Okay. Whereas I cap and J cap are specific quantities called unit vectors along X axis and Y axis. Okay, so that's it for today's lecture, people. See you next time.